So have a look at sum number 3, page number 44 of your science textbooks. So in case you don't have a science textbook, please pause the video and bring your science textbook and bring your notebook to write down. So you have there, Umesh has two bulbs having resistances of 15 and 30 ohms. Okay, so there he's got two bulbs of 15, okay. So there are two bulbs, so I'll say this is sum number 3, page number 44, okay, page number 44. So Umesh has two bulbs and there are two bulbs, so let's say R1 and R2. So R1 is 15 ohms and see the second bulb is R2, which is 30 ohms. Okay, so Umesh has two bulbs. He wants to connect them in a circuit. Okay, he wants to put in a circuit. But if he connects them one at a time, the filament gets burnt. Okay, the saying if he connects them at the same one at a time, the filament gets burnt. So answer the following. Okay, the filament is getting burnt. Okay, that means the current is increasing. Current is increasing. Okay, when the current increases, the filament will get burnt. So what is the problem here? They're asking you answer the following. Which method should he use to connect the bulbs so that the bulbs don't get burnt? Which method should he use? Now we have learned in this lesson, the only way to lower the current is to lower the total resistance. In other words, he has to use which method? There are two ways of connecting resistances of bulbs. What are the two ways we learned in this chapter? Series and parallel. In series, what happens? Higher the current, higher the resistance, higher the current. Yes? The resistance is more, so the current will be more, so the bulbs are getting burnt. But in parallel, the resistance is less, and so the current also will be less, and so the bulbs will not get burnt. So what will you suggest this person, Umesh? You have to tell Umesh, Baba, you have to connect the two bulbs in parallel. Don't connect them in series. If you connect them in series, it will get burnt, so you better connect them in parallel. Okay, so the answer to question number A, okay, is which method he has to use? So he has to connect the in parallel. So he has to connect the two resistance in parallel. Second, what are the characteristics of this way of connecting the bulbs depending on the answer of A above? What are the characteristics they are asking? What are the characteristics of this way? So the characteristics are given to you on page number 42. Okay, can you see, please turn to page number 42. Okay, page number 42, can you see? So can you see the green box on the top? What are they given there? If a number of resistors are connected in parallel, then what happens? Then these five things, can you see number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4 and number 5. These five are the characteristics. Now I want to just bring your attention to that fifth point. What is the fifth point is saying? That this arrangement is used to reduce the resistance in the circuit. This arrangement is used to reduce the resistance in the circuit. And if the resistance decreases, automatically what will happen is, okay, clear? So I hope this is clear. So the answer to question number B is on page number 42. Okay. So you see all the five characteristics which are given in the green box. You need to write those five characters. That is a character for connecting resistances in parallel. Now third one. We go to the third one. What is the question number C? It says, what will be the effective resistance in the above circuit? So what will be the effective or the overall or the net resistance, okay, the total resistance in the circuit, what will be the effective resistance? Now since they are connected in parallel, we all know the formula for parallel, so the answer, so we will have to solve it. So I say 1 upon Rp is 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. So 1 upon Rp, I don't know how to find out. 1 upon R1, R1 kitna hai? 15, barabar. Plus 1 upon R2, R2 is 30. Okay. So I say 1 upon Rp equal to, now what do? You have to find the raise LCM 15-30. No, when the denominators are different, can you add the fractions? No, you have to make the denominator same. So what will I do? I'll take the LCM of 15 and 30. So what is the LCM of 15 and 30? It's very easy. You can do it mentally also. Why? Because 15, 30 is a multiple of 15. 15 goes in 30, no? 15 to the 30. Whatever 15 to the 30. Whenever one number is a multiple of the other, the higher number becomes the LCM and the lower number becomes the HCF. So HCF is 15, LCM is 30. Why? When does it happen? When the bigger number is a multiple of the smaller number. Okay? So 15 and 30 ka LCM is 30. Then I have to write 1, the numerator into. Then ask yourselves, 15 goes in 30 how many times? 2 times. 2 plus, open the bracket. Why plus here? Plus. Then you have 1 into. Fine. Again you write 30 goes. Ask here, 30 goes in 30 how many times? So 1 time. So I have 1 upon RP equal to 2 ones are 2 and 1 ones are 1. So 2 plus 1 becomes 3. So I get 3 upon 30. So I get 3 ones are 3 tens are. Now can you see the numerator is same? 1 1. So if the see both the fractions are equal. So if the numerator is same, the denominator also will be the same. That means RP will be equal to 10. So the total resistance RP will be 10 ohms. So can you see here? See the thing here. Can you see the concept wise? See the understand the concept. Whenever you connect resistance in parallel, the value will be less than each of the resistance. So what were the resistance you use? Which bulbs you use? You use a 15 ohm bulb and a 30 ohm bulb. But when you connect it in parallel, the total resistance became less than both of them. But you use two bulbs of 15, 30 ohm, but the total resistance became 10 ohms. Okay? So, can you see the resistance becomes less? So, if the resistance becomes less, you don't have much problem. Yes? So, the bulbs will not get burned. Okay? But if you were to connect in series, so in series what happens? It gets added. 15 plus 30 becomes 45. The total resistance becomes more than the each of the resistances. No? In series, you all know. No? If I have to do it in series, RS, what will be the answer? R1 plus R2. Barabar? So, I will get 15 plus 30. 45 ohms. So can you see the difference? In series, the total value, total resistance or the net resistance, the overall resistance will be greater than each of the two resistances. In parallel, it will be less than each of the two resistances. Clear? The concept is clear? I hope this is clear, boys. Okay. So, I hope that these are the only sums which are actually there in this lesson. And okay, so we'll move on to question number 9.